Hey, so as we told you guys, we're going to try some different genres as we go along the journey. So last week we did a little bit of a country-ish genre. So today what we're going to do is it's going to be all old school hymns. So I hope some of you are familiar with those. If you are, sing them out. And I know some of you may not be familiar with some of them, so it's a great opportunity to kind of learn and see where the foundation of our contemporary worship comes from. So we've asked Mrs. King to play the piano for us because I cannot play piano, so I just throw that out there. So we're going to do that. We hope you enjoy it. We hope that you benefit from it as well. So I'm going to open up a prayer in just a second. I do want to remind you guys, don't forget we're going to do a question and answer. And the questions are no holds barred. You can ask whatever you want to ask. So put them on a piece of paper, a sticky note, slide them right in there. Completely anonymous, so we won't point anybody out or embarrass anybody. So that's coming up towards the end of the month. So if you guys have questions, Bible questions, life questions in general, just throw them in there. So one of my favorite questions so far was, why is the high school always grumpy? So I don't really have an answer for that, so I'm not even gonna bring that one to the Q&A chapel, but that's been my favorite question so far. So there's been some other good ones as well. So if you guys do have questions, don't forget to bring them to us. So let's do this. Bow your heads and let's start with prayer. Father, we love you so much, and we thank you for this day. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. Most of all, we thank you for the salvation. Some of these older hymns, Father, that through the lyrics you would just speak into our hearts, God. I pray that for some they bring back memories. I pray that for others they open our eyes to the foundation of what we listen to in churches now. God, I pray that you would bless everything that is said, everything that is done. And we pray these things in your name, in the name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen, amen. Hey, what's our pivot point for this month? Anybody remember? Protection. Thank you, Chase. God's protection. And so the first song that we're going to sing, it's a really, really old song. It's called It Is Well With My Soul. And I wanted to tell you just a brief, I won't tell you the whole story behind it. The guy who wrote it, his name is Horatio Spafford. And in the 1870s, he experienced in Chicago, there was a great fire in Chicago, and he lost everything. He lost his business. He lost everything. A few months later, he had a four-year-old son that died due to scarlet fever. So he lost everything, then his son dies. He figured that it would be good for his family to take a vacation, so he buys tickets for his wife and his four daughters to get on a boat and to come over to Europe to have a little bit of vacation. He was going to come a little bit later. Well, his wife and his four girls get on the ship. They make their way to England, and the ship wrecks. And he loses four of his daughters, and his wife, Anna, barely survives, but she survives. So he gets the news. He gets on a boat. He's absolutely heartbroken, and he's on his way from America to England. And while he's there, he pins the words that you're about to hear. Basically, no matter what is happening, it is well with my soul. So you guys enjoy today's hymn.
Thank you. Blessed assurance.
Let's do this. Everybody stand real quick. I want everybody to sing that chorus just a couple of times. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. I just want you to take a few minutes. I know some of you aren't used to hymns. You're used to contemporary. You're used to a little bit more soulful. But what a beautiful song we're talking about. Turning our eyes towards Jesus. Looking full in his wonderful face. So you guys just sing that with us.